Hey guys, I hope you are all doing well. So after trying different cooling products for the ROG ALLY and oftentimes getting disappointing results, I came up with an idea to make a DIY cooling solution. Let me introduce you to this Lego made stand that is equipped with dual NOCTUA 80mm high performance fans. But first, I want to give my gratitude to my brother who is passionate in Lego building and has helped in designing the cooling stand. I'm really thankful for the work he has done and it was really fun making it. With emotions aside, let's talk a bit about the Lego set used in this project. It's called Lots of Bricks and basically has over 1000 bricks in different colors. I chose orange and brown to give the same fan's color accent. As for the base, it's a mix of black and white that got inspired by the ALLY colors. We also intentionally used this set only to make it easy and possible for everyone that is interested in building it. I link the set in the description. Please let me know if you will be interested in seeing a tutorial on how to make it from scratch. I'm certain that my bro will be happy to do so. Now let's get over and talk about the fans. At size of 80mm, they can cover the entire ventilated intake area, pushing fresh air directly while also being trapped in this cage to be firm and not leak air outside. Spec-wise, the fans have 2200 RPM, airflow of 55.5 cubic meter per hour and static pressure at 2.37 mm H2O. And what's really awesome that they are too silent, with max noise at 17.7 dB. I can barely hear them in comparison to the ALLY internal fans. Also surprisingly, they consume only 0.75 watts, while most other fans at this spec consume at least 2 watts. It's incredible how NOCTUA is able to deliver all of this with little required power. If you are familiar with NOCTUA, you know they make the best computer fans, and that's why I chose them for mission cooling ROG ALLY. So I'll also link the fans page in the description. Please make sure to get the 5V model that works with only USB, not the ordinary one which is 12V. And as for connecting the fans, I got this Y splitter that takes two PWM and outputs them to USB 3. This way, you will end up with one single cable for both. Additionally, if you want to connect the fans directly to the ROG ALLY, there is this Type-C adapter. But naturally, you can easily connect it to a multi-adapter like I have here. And now the time has arrived to show the cooling performance. But first, to be clear, I want to explain how I'll be doing the test. I have the ALLY connected to power adapter, and in Armory Crate, I made a power profile with max 30 watts. As for the fan curve, it's flat 75% for the two fans in order to give accurate results as much as possible, while also not have a very high noise level. With ambient temp at 23 Celsius, I'm going to drive through Night City for 30 minutes with the fans turned off. After that, we'll check the temps and then I'll turn on the fans to see their effectiveness in cooling. So 30 minutes have passed and the checking screen temp, it's about 39 Celsius or 102 Fahrenheit. As for the internal temp, it reached max of 70 Celsius. And now I'll turn the fans on and drive again for 30 minutes. And back we are. This time the screen temp is roughly 29 Celsius or 84 Fahrenheit. This is quite impressive because it means the cooling power of these fans is able to reach its way to the screen. As for the internal temp, according to the ALLY monitor tool, it's 65 Celsius. However, Afterburner occasionally indicates 63 Celsius for the GPU. Considering the limited ventilation on the ALLY back cover, a decrease of 5 to 6 degrees is quite reasonable. So what do you think of the result? Did it meet your expectation? Let me know in the comments. And if you like my content, please subscribe to stay updated on my latest videos. I don't want to spoil it, but I'm working on something that might show the true benefit of this cooling stand. Don't miss it out. Catch you in the next one.